Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is the 18th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. O God, come to my assistance. O Lord, make haste to help me. You are my rescuer, my help. O Lord, do not delay.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today is St. John Maria Vianney Sunday. No? So please do remember in a very special way, kami hong mga pare, pray for us. He is our patron, especially the patron of parish priests. No? So please do pray for the priests of our church as we remember St. John Maria Vianney today. My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. Draw near to your servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, that for those who glory in you as their Creator and Guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. First reading from the book of Exodus. The whole Israelite community grumbled against Moses and Aaron. The Israelites said to them, "Would that we had died at the Lord's hand in the land of Egypt, as we sat by our flesh pots and ate our fill of bread. But you had to lead us into this desert to make the whole community die of famine." Then the Lord said to Moses, "I will now rain down bread from heaven for you. Each day the people are to go out and gather their daily portion. Thus will I test them to see whether they follow my instructions or not. I have heard the grumbling of the Israelites. Tell them, in the evening twilight you shall eat flesh, and in the morning you shall have your fill of bread, so that you may know that I, the Lord, am your God." In the evening quail came up and covered the camp. In the morning a dew lay all about the camp, and when the dew evaporated, there on the surface of the desert were the fine flakes like hoar frost on the ground. On seeing it, the Israelites asked one another, "What is this?" For they did not know what it was. But Moses told them, "This is the bread that the Lord has given you to eat." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
What we have heard and know, and what our fathers have declared to us, we will declare to the generation to come the glorious deeds of the Lord and his strength and the wonders that he wrought.
The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
He commanded the skies above and opened the doors of heaven. He rained manna upon them for food and gave them heavenly bread.
The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
Man ate the bread of angels, food he sent them in abundance, and he brought them to his holy land, to the mountains his right hand had won.
The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
Second reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I declare and testify in the Lord that you must no longer live as the Gentiles do in the futility of their minds. That is not how you learned Christ, assuming that you have heard of him and were taught in him as truth is in Jesus, that you should put away the old self of your former way of life, corrupted through deceitful desires, and be renewed in the spirit of your minds, and put on the new self, created in God's way, in righteousness and holiness of truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. One does not live on bread alone, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of God. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
When the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they themselves got into boats and came to Capernaum looking for Jesus. And when they found him across the sea, they said to him, Rabbi, when did you get here? Jesus answered them and said, Amen, I say to you, you are looking for me not because you saw signs, but because you ate the loaves and were filled. Do not work for food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For in him the Father God has set his seal. So they said to him, What can we do to accomplish the works of God? Jesus answered and said to them, This is the work of God, that you believe in the one he sent. So they said to him, What sign can you do that you may see and believe in you? What can you do? Our ancestors ate manna in the desert, as it is written, He gave them bread from heaven to eat. So Jesus said to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, it was neither Moses who gave the bread from heaven. My Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. So they said to him, Sir, give us this bread always. Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So today we have the continuation from the multiplication of the loaves and fish. Last Sunday, no. So we now have this, the discourse on the bread of life, no. So, of course, we will read this. I think the whole month of August will be the discourse on the bread of life, and at the very end of the last Sunday of August, then you have the conclusion of this section of the Gospel of John, no. So for today, I'd like to put this next few Sundays, no, the next four Sundays of August. I'd like to put it within the context of our experience of the pandemic. Maybe it's a good time to reflect on one aspect of the pandemic, no? You know, one of the things that I think the pandemic gave us is a renewed sense of spirituality, no? A renewed sense of spirituality that for many, no, it was a renewed sense of the devotion to the Mass, one. And then, of course, you have many rosary groups, no? Then you have a lot of people doing Bible reflection or Bible study because of the pandemic, no? And also, I think a sense of community was also formed, no, around these devotions, no? So what I invite you to reflect on now, this Sunday, as we will talk about the bread of life in the coming Sundays, I'd like you to go back, no, to that experience of renewed spirituality. From that is the first point that we will reflect on, no? And then the second point is that to ask ourselves, where are we now, no? Then the third point is sort of trying to lay out the themes in the coming Sundays, no? So that's a third point for reflection. First, about the renewed spirituality, no? And again, it's always good to go back to those early days of the pandemic when so many things were uncertain. And yet, I think those moments gave us very, very special graces. The grace of, because we are all locked down, staying together in one community, we had a renewed sense of community, either your families or religious communities. So I think that was a big, big grace, no, during the start of the pandemic. And people valued that, no? And of course, there is the grace of renewed sense of prayer. There are, because to this day they exist, no? There are many, many groups praying the rosary, praying for healing, praying for the intentions of others that were formed during the pandemic, no? And to this day continue. And you know, and almost anywhere I go, be it here in the provinces, abroad, when you see a Filipino, there's always they're thanking, no? They're thanking the Kapamilya Daily Mass, no? Because they were able to renew first of all, for some, they're able to continue their devotion to the Mass. And many people would share how the members of their families before they no longer went to Mass, but because of the availability of the Mass, they had gone back to going to Mass. No? So there's a renewed sense of prayer and spirituality. No? And I think this is what the Lord also is saying in the Gospel. No? Because of that multiplication of the loaves and fish, people now were searching for more. No? And the Lord is saying, no, you are searching because you have had your fill, but seek now, no, the greater things. No? Seek now what is more spiritual. No? And that brings us to the second point. No? Where are we now, no, in terms of our devotions, of our renewed spirituality? No? Now that we have opened up and back to normal. Of course, I still meet a lot of people who share that they still go to Mass daily. No? They go to Sunday Mass in their churches, but before they would not go to Mass daily. But because, again, of the availability of the Mass, they go to Mass daily. No? And they like reflecting. They like listening to the reflection. So the second point, no, where are we now? No, I think it's important for us not to forget, no, the graces and blessings given to us, no, during those times of uncertainty. Because during those times of uncertainty, we were very, very vulnerable. And we opened ourselves to God's grace. I think we must not forget that. Because I think that is a very important, you might say, quality of our faith. To open our hearts, our minds, and our spirit to the Lord. No? A sense of vulnerability to God. So that God's grace may enter our lives. So maybe the second point to reflect on. No? Where are we now in terms of these renewed devotions that we had in the early part of the pandemic? As the Lord mentions in the Gospel, no, seek the greater things, no, seek for the what is greater than the manna in the desert. Seek for the bread of life, no, that is the entire theme of the coming weeks, no. So the second point to assess, no, and to honestly sort of assess where we are now with regard to these renewed devotions, no. And then the third and last point is that just to preview the next Sundays, no, that hopefully in the coming Sundays we will begin to understand, no, more deeply the bread of life and our devotion to the Mass. So that is what we will do the coming Sundays, no, to understand more and more our devotion to the Mass and to remember that part of the gift of sacraments, it promises to give us the graces that we need to live out, no, the character or the grace of that sacrament. For example, in the sacrament of reconciliation, it gives us the grace of healing, no, and reconciling with God and others, no, against whom we have committed the sin. So that is the grace promised by the sacrament. For the Mass, the grace promise is that for us to live out in the day-to-day our discipleship, our character as followers of Christ, as disciples of Christ. That's why the memorial wherein we recall the passion, death, and resurrection of Christ is the pattern of Christian living, no? That we renew every day, no, as we go to Mass. So we will look at this in the coming weeks. But today I want you to assess, no, this Sunday, sort of create a baseline data so that as we go to the reflections in the coming weeks, we may really hopefully renew our devotion to the Mass, a gift at the beginning of the pandemic, and hopefully a gift that we continue to remember and deepen and hopefully lead us to a deeper understanding, appreciation, and really the reality of living out the graces of the Holy Eucharist. Together now, let us profess our faith.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Father, you satisfied the hungry with loaves and fish through your Son, Jesus Christ. Help us become more and more like your Son as we pray. Lord, hear our prayer.
That the service rendered by those who lead the church serve as food that brings life and nourishment to the needy, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That government leaders and other public servants may implement and promote policies that answer the basic needs of the people whom they serve, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are sick, lonely, anxious, and depressed may find strength and healing in Jesus, the bread of life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember, continue to remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And we pray also for the continued good health of the Holy Father, Pope Francis. We pray for his intentions, especially his prayers for peace. And let's also continue to pray for those who suffered during the recent floods and Typhoon Karina. And let's pray for the people also helping them. And let's also pray for the coming Synod on Synodality. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth, he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering, cancelled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint John Maria Vianney, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And let us now offer the Oratio Imperata for peace.
God, our Heavenly Father, Lord of peace and justice, we humbly come before you during this time of escalating geopolitical tensions in our part of the world. Through the years, you have sustained our faith in you as a nation. It is our faith in your divine providence that has made us survive the countless natural and human-caused calamities that have come our way in our history as a people. Spare us, Lord, from the horrors of war. Hear our pleas as we cry out to you. Have mercy on us, Lord. Rescue us from the malevolent forces that influence world leaders. For we believe that our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. We pray for our leaders entrusted with making crucial decisions for our nation. We place all our hopes in you, seeking your forgiveness and mercy for the times when our fears and suspicions have tainted our perceptions with ethnic biases and prejudices verging on racism. We earnestly pray, Lord, that you make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us bring love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady, Queen of Peace,
pray for us.
Saint Michael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Francis of Assisi,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Saint Ignatius of Loyola,
pray for us. And let us pray. Accompany with constant protection, O Lord, those you renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never-failing care for them, make them worthy of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat. And again, I just want to update you on our Kapamilya Daily Mass Collection. Our total for the Daily Mass Collection is 9,719,569.58. No? Out of that, 3,582,382 pesos and 4 centavos were allotted to the programs, no? the seven legacy programs. And then the donations for the Mindanao flooding is 2,699,428.73. No? And then for the Carina, so far we have collected 434,392 pesos and 1 centavo. No? And again, we'd like to appeal again for the donations to Carina. More and more dioceses have requested for our help. We have given most certainly much more than 400,000 to the different dioceses. And then for the annual giving fund, no, for the Alecapa Expanded Program, we are now up to 17,155,701.07. So maraming salamat po. And please continue to support both the Kapamilya Daily Mass gifts and then also the Alecapa Expanded Program. So have a good Sunday and have a blessed Sunday. And please do pray, no, on our devotion to the Mass. Thank you po.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. I can't turn water into wine, but I can turn a frown into a smile. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. Every blessing I receive is a miracle that I can share. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa.
Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.